Let's add in two attributes to our DTD. So as I indicated earlier, we're going to add in two. One is the numbers for lines and a type on note, so we can indicate a different kind of note, a contextual note, biographical note, something like that. Okay, so the way to add in attributes is directly after the element declaration. Let's create a space. And the syntax is at list, even though it's attribute list, even though it's only one attribute, still it's called at list. Same syntax, exclamation mark. Remember, put your caps on and type at list. Then you declare the element on which this attribute will occur. In our case, it is line. I'm going to use n for number. That's the attribute name. And afterwards, I am going to indicate that this is C data, character data, not parsed. That's the syntax. Remember capital again. And it is implied, which means I don't have to use it. And I am going to close that angle bracket. Ah, okay, so for some reason I have a trademark there for that error message instead of the hashtag I was looking for. Okay, there we go. It's not necessary to put your attribute declaration after the element name, but it is good practice. So let's do the note one. In fact, we could do what I did before, is just copy that, get rid of that stray note, and I am going to, instead of call it number, I'm going to say that's a type attribute, and again, the same syntax, C data and implied. So let's go down here to our DTD. Let's just save that. And you see the document is valid. Let me now see, can I put on my line a number? So just create an extra space and there you see the attribute number. And my note, let's do the same thing. Yes, and here it's the type. And I can put the value here. So let's call, I'm going to call the type as contextual. Here, because we said it's C data, I could type whatever I want. And this is line number one. My document is still valid. Let's save it and you can see validate, no problem. And while I'm here, let's just put the same number verse, because I realized we may have many verses and would like to number them. Let's save that and make sure we can do that. So this is the first verse. Yes, N is coming up. So I'm going to put one here. And let me do this again. Yes, verse two. And verse 3. Perfect. And it parses. And now we have a DTD with element names and attributes.